Hey everyone, JJ here, back again with another video. It's gonna be a short one today, so let's get straight into it. So for starters, let's talk about the number one mod that I would recommend you guys get, irrespective of what bike you ride. What I'm talking about, of course, is the throttle assist, this little thing right here. I came across this while researching how to deal with thumb pain while riding. I have this thing where this joint kind of starts aching whenever I use my thumb for anything. And it would get progressively worse the more I use it. The throttle assist, sometimes referred to as crampusters, is a simple enough design. It's just a piece of plastic that snaps onto your throttle. It takes off all the weight of your fingers and your thumb so that you use your palm more to actuate the throttle. Some people place it out of the way for most of the time and just use it instead when they get a long stretch of open road, if you will. I found that after only a short while of using it, it's impossible to go back. I always keep a spare under the seat. Yeah, it's life-changing. So let's see this thing in action. So as you can clearly see, even if it seems like I'm gripping the bars, I'm actually not holding on with any fingers or my thumb. I just let my fingers curl over naturally because that's what they want to do. All the weight is on my palm. Because in truth, you don't need to be holding on to the bars to ride the bike. The bike will go without you even holding on, as you can clearly see. So yeah, this helps me have a lighter touch on the bike and gives me more control that way. You can get these for around $1 on eBay with free shipping. So yeah. That's my number one mod that I would recommend. So in the very first video in this channel, I talk about learning to love riding here. And that's what I had to do. I had to learn to love riding here. So yeah, let's talk about that for a while. Now, most people in Malé treat the bike solely as a means of transportation, as a way of getting from point A to point B in a fast, efficient way. And that's great. I'm totally behind that. But if you can make the journey fun as well, that's just more bang for your buck. So I remember after I got my license, after like the first 2 weeks of riding, when the novelty wears off, it gets kind of lame. You start seeing that the roads are horrible and the traffic is just incessant all the time. So yeah, it starts to not look as cool as when you first started riding. And then yeah, most people just use the bike as a means of transport from that. For this video, I'm gonna focus on those two things that I mentioned, the horrible road conditions and the horrible traffic conditions in Malé. So what we usually get are not really the potholes, but really sudden dips in the road. They're so sudden that most bikes suspensions just can't take them. Here's how to deal with them. Right when you approach one, get some firm purchase with your feet and push back a little on the seat so that all your leg muscles are a bit tensed up. And then with your hands, just let go of the throttle as you hit the dip. The bike will immediately dive down and just come back up and meet you in your hands. And all of the rest of the shocks will be taken by your knees and you won't feel a thing in your back. Let's just hit this one real quick. See, I feel nothing. You see the dip coming? Slide back on your seat with your leg muscles tensed. Let go of the bars. And that's it. You don't feel a thing. Now, I don't want to, but just for the sake of this video, I'm gonna hit the next one whilst firmly gripping the bar. And I'm just not gonna do anything with my legs and I'll see how that feels. So that little one, I felt the shock going through my arms all the way to my spine, and then it just kind of shot up to my skull, and at the same time it kind of went down my spine as well. I did not like how that felt. Let's hit another one. Nope. Alright, now let's talk about traffic. Now, like most of you, I'm usually out on an errand if I'm out on my bike. So here's what I do to simultaneously improve my riding, beat the traffic, all the while having fun. So I usually do this in these small one-way roads. I prefer them for the most part. So I make it a challenge to beat traffic. I make it so that I have to be in front of anyone who is there. But the thing is, I can't be pushy at all. So going down this one ways, you'll always see a car or truck with a bunch of bikes held up behind it. My target would be to first be at the front of all the bikes and then eventually to pass whatever four-wheel vehicle is blocking the way. And all the while, I cannot be pushy. I just have to play it smart, find clean lines and just go through. That's the whole exercise here. So once I'm clear of that pack, I'll make myself over to the next one as quickly as I can. We of course don't get as much traffic as we used to due to the pandemic, but it's still good practice. I'll just follow this guy as he passes. I found that hanging back a bit further makes it easier to find the lines. Because if you're too close to the vehicle, you just won't have enough room to maneuver around it. I do wish we had more traffic so that I could show you guys how this goes usually. It's always a car and then a bunch of bikes and then you pass them and it's always the same again and again and again. More spread out today, but yeah, this is what I do so that I don't go crazy on these rides. Gives me something to do all the while I'm improving my abilities on the bike, my braking, my steering and my throttle control. All benefits from doing active exercises like these. So yeah, the next time you go out on an errand, go out with a purpose. I play additional games like forcing myself not to plant a foot, or just riding around using only one hand, or sometimes I do with this throttle assist, I do just open palm only riding. It's just something to help me improve my riding all the while keeping me amused. Now I said I prefer one-way roads and I'm gonna talk about that a bit more in the next video. I'm planning to do like a tier list of the main roads in Mahade. I think that will be a fun one. So anyways, thank you all very much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. And I'll see you in the next one.